Welcome to Camp Hope AME Church at 114 Camp Hope Church Road, Macon, Georgia, 31211. It is a glorious day to be alive in the midst of what is going on. God has truly blessed each and every one of us. If you can't know someone that can't tune in via Facebook, we can be reached at 978-990-5041. Access code 675984. Be with us and listen to us as we listen to our praise the worship song. Nothing like your presence. And remember, we do not own the rights of any of this music that we're playing today.
Your presence, Lord, all I want is to be with you.
Sylvia Pitts, welcome all. Join us in this praise and worship. Nothing like to be in your presence, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes. Nothing like it. Yes, Lord.
You are God, the only one and
the living God. Oh, thank you, God, for sending your Son Jesus, for you need to be God in our presence, Lord. You are God, Lord. Hallelujah. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Our feet shall stand within thy gates, O Jerusalem. Say with me, for a day in thy courts is better than a thousand elsewhere. I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than dwell in the tents of wickedness. Because of the house of the Lord our God, I will seek thy good. Join in with me this morning. Those that be planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God. Blessed are they that dwelleth in thine house. Lord, I have loved thy habitation, the place where thy honor dwelleth. Join in with me, for the Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silence before him. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. O Lord, my rock and my redeemer, join in with me. O sing unto the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. I will sing of loyalty and of justice to you. O Lord, I will sing. And join in with us today for our hymn of praise, I Need You to Survive. Hallelujah.
Everybody look at somebody and tell them, I need you.
Come on, let's sing. I need you. You need me. We're all a part of God's body. Come on, say, stand with me. Agree with me. We're all a part of God's body. Come on, it is his will that every need be supplied. Come on, you are important to me. I need you to survive. Come on. Yes, you are important to me. I need you to survive.
Hallelujah.
Come on.
I need you.
You need me. We're all a part of God's body. Stand with me, agree with me, we're all a part of God's body. Hallelujah, come on, and every need be supplied. Welcome, John Lowe. Welcome. Valerie, come on, join in with us. Maddie, come on, join in with us. I need you to survive. Oh, come on, sing with us. Sing with us this morning. Hallelujah. Come on, praise God. Oh, all the families represented. Come on, come on. Let's sing, I pray for you. Come on, say, you pray for me. I love you. I need you to survive. I won't harm you with words from my mouth. I love you. Come on, I need you to survive. Come on, let's say it together. You pray for me. I love you. I need you to survive. I won't harm you with words from my mouth. I love you. I need you. Come on, come on. I pray for you. Come on, you pray for me. Come on, I love you. I need you to survive. Survive. I won't harm you with words from my mouth. Come on, tell God I love you. Tell your neighbor I love you. Tell him I need you to survive. Where you are, whoever's around, tell them you love them. Tell them I need you to survive. Tell them I won't harm you with words from my mouth. Come on, I love you. I need you to survive. Come on out there all across this land, all across the world. Come on, tell the world I love you. Tell them you need them to survive. Come on, you won't harm them with words from your mouth. Come on. Hallelujah. Yeah. Yeah. As we turn the music down some and play it in the background, let us go into prayer. Oh, Lord God, God, you are all our all in all. We just thank you this morning for you allowing us to be in your presence. We thank you this morning for allowing us to be a representation of you in the name of Jesus. Lord, through our prayer requests, we've asked for prayer for Judith Young, who's suffering with cancer in Louisiana. We've asked for prayer for Calvin and Sylvia Pitts in Macon. We've asked for prayer for Ms. Barabino in New Orleans. We've asked for prayer for the Young family also in Canada. We've asked for prayer for those that are located out there in Washington State, the Maccabees. We've asked, there's been asking for prayer for those that are in Texas, the Calvins. We've asked for those that are need prayer of the Stringfellows. We've asked for prayer for all of these. Lord, we bring them before your throne of mercy. We bring Camp Hope. We bring all of those that's monitoring them and their families before your throne of grace and mercy. And we ask to have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us in the name of Jesus, Lord. Lord, we just thank you for keeping us safe during these times. We thank you for allowing us to be able to sustain us during these times and in this season. Lord, if we had 10,000 tongues, God, we could not thank you enough, Lord. We say hallelujah, Lord. And oh, Lord, we ask that you would forgive us for our sins. Hallelujah. That we have done in thought, word, and deed, Lord. And Lord, we pray that for whatever reason you have allowed this, let your purpose be fulfilled. Let us wake up, Lord, and see you, Lord. Let us wake up and see our family members again. Let us love being around one another, being able to sit and congregate with one another, being able to join in one another, to talk to one another, to eat with one another. All those things have brought us back together as a unit in a family, Lord. For some it's hard, Lord, for they haven't done it in a while. Lord, we ask that you would intercede right there in the name of Jesus. For some of us that have children, we didn't realize what the teachers were going through with our children, but we realize now, Lord, let us be more supportive of our teachers our caregivers, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We send a special prayer for Sylvia Pence's goal. She's a home provider where she goes in home health care. Protect the Lord in the name of Jesus. We pray for those that are in the nursing homes, Lord, those that are in a hospital, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we pray for our government. We pray for our government from national to global to state to city, to town, even our counselors, even our supervisors. We pray for all of the leaders, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Touch their hearts, for we know that you are in control of their hearts, Lord. And Lord, we ask some of these decisions that's being made, Lord, let them be the right decisions that's made, Lord. Let them be in your will and in your way, Lord. And no matter what we decide to do, Lord, put a hedge of protection around us, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Lord, we don't understand what's going on with this coronavirus, Lord, but you do. So we're going to trust you, Lord. We put our lives in your hands, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We pray that we find a cure. We pray that we find a vaccination. Those that are suffering with it will be able to beat it and conquer it. And those that don't, Lord, we pray that they know you, that the next place that they will be is with you in your presence,
you,
Lord.
Lord,
we pray for those families that have lost loved ones because of this virus.
Yes.
Let them know that you have them, Lord. Let them know that the prayers of the righteous avail of much, not just for on this side, but on the other side as well, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for our sins. And Lord, let us be in his command to love one another and love you more than we love ourselves and love our neighbor, Lord. And let us be the love of you in this world, Lord, in the name of Jesus. But Lord, we've gotten caught up in trying to emulate Christ during his time, emulate Christ during his walk, Lord. But we know that your Son said greater works that we shall do, because he goes and will send another, the Holy Spirit. Allow your Holy Spirit to work in us that we might go better, greater, do more things, Lord, greater works as he has commanded us to do.
Yeah.
Let us go out in the highways and in the byways, everywhere we need to go, Lord, and make disciples and baptizing them in the name of Jesus. But remember, it's to glorify you, Lord, through your Son, Jesus. We have no powers, only by the power of the Holy Spirit. It's by thy Spirit, Lord. So allow that your Holy Spirit, to allow that Holy Spirit to work through us. Let him comfort us. Let him keep us. Let us bring us back to remembrance those things that we need to say. Lord, this is our prayer. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. And Lord, I'd ask right now that you would allow them to join in a cappella with me, with I love you. I love you, Lord, today. I love you. I love you. I love you, Lord, today. because you care for me in such a special way. That's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. My heart, my mind, my soul belong to you. You paid the price for me way back on Calvary. That's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. We just thank you. We praise you. We've been having a few difficulties with the stream buffering, but pray with us as we go through these times. Amen. So now we are going to our scripture. If you would join us in our scripture reading today, we have two scriptures. One comes from John, the 14th chapter, the 23rd verse. The second comes from Luke, the 2nd chapter, the 49th through the 50th verse. Amen. Again, John, the 14th chapter, the 23rd verse. Luke, the 2nd chapter, the 49th through the 50th verse. Amen. We pray that you have your swords with us. We pray that the buffering have stopped and you're back live with us. John, the 14th chapter, the 23rd verse. Luke, the 2nd chapter, the 49th through the 50th verse. Jesus replied, "Anyone who loves me will obey my teaching. My Father will love them, and we will come to them and make our home with them." And now Luke chapter 2, verses 49 through 50. "Why were you searching for me?" he asked. "Didn't you know I had to be in my Father's house?" But they did not understand what he was saying to them. I've read for you John, the 14th chapter, the 23rd verse, and Luke, the 2nd chapter, the 49th through the 50th verse. "From all that dwell below the sky, let the Creator's praise arise. Let the Creator's name be sung through every land by every tongue. From all that dwells below the sky, let thy Creator's praise arise. Let the Redeemer's name be spread through every land by every tongue." The summary of the Decalogue: hear what Christ our Savior said. "Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it: thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets." Let us sing Glory Patri together. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Amen. It is now time for our benevolent and our tithes and our offering. We ask that you would join with us. We have a button down that you can join in with Giblify. Amen. We're also working on getting Cash App and other forms. But if you don't are not able to give through Giblify, we ask that you would mail in your offering to us at 114 Camp Hope Church Road, Macon, Georgia, 31211. Again, that's Camp Hope AME Church, 114 Camp Hope Church Road, Macon, Georgia, 31211. Amen. And now we're getting ready for the word. And our word today will be brought to you by one of our ministerial staff, by the Reverend Ida Sue Graham. So we, after the next election, we ask that you would prepare your heart and your mind to hear from God through the Reverend Ida Sue Graham. God bless you.
Everything we need, Lord, is in your presence. Lord, we thank you. We thank you today that we can be in your presence. We thank you that we can praise you, that we can sing songs of praise and worship to your holy name. Church, let's lift up this chorus together. I want to go.
Camp Hope family and all out in the lands. Let me just start with my prayer. Father God, right now, my heavenly God, just touch right now. Come into me, Father God. Move Ida Sue out the way and let you come forth. But we're doing a new thing here. Everyone in the world is doing a new thing here. We're all out of our comfort right now. And I know that you are with me and with everyone right now. So just touch, Father God. So the word come forth, Father God, is brought forth through you, for you, by you. This is your servant's prayer. In Jesus' name, amen. The scripture has been read, but I would like to go over just a little bit again, please. I'm going to be looking at John, verse 23. Jesus replied, "Anyone who loves me will obey my teaching. My Father will love them, and we will come to them and make our home with them." That's a lot of words right there. The first thing I notice in that scripture is that we have to be comfortable with the Lord. We have to allow him to come into us. So we want to experience his presence in our lives. And we think about all the things that's going on right now. How do we experience God with all the stuff that's going on? It's very hard to ignore what is going on around us because it's everywhere. You cut the radio on. I usually cut the radio on and I can just listen to my music all day, or I can listen to the podcast that I love to listen to. But now when I turn that on, I am just not hearing my God talk or my God music or the R&B that I have chose to listen to. Oh yes, I listen to R&B because I still have feelings just like Jesus had feelings about everything. He walked all over the world from this place and that place to get acquainted with his people and know exactly how we thought and exactly what we heard. And exactly where we went. How do I experience God's presence in your life today. How do I do that? Well, life is busy and it's filled with distractions all around us. We hear so much about this virus and we're hearing about so much about death. But some of the radio stations and TV stations have decided to give a good thing at the end of their broadcasts. After all that bad has come, to let you know that the light is still shining and there's some good that's going about. It is so easy to get caught up with the cares and errors and the worries of the world that we lose sight on what really matters. In the book of Luke, we see here that Mary and Joseph had a little boy. His name was Jesus. And it was time for them to go to the festival of Passover, the Passover festival, which they had to go to every year. Now, Jesus at that time was about 12 years old. Now, we all are used to going to festivals. We find out now we can't go. We usually go to concerts. I, too, had to cancel concert tickets. We find out that we can't go. But at this festival that they both went to at this time, it was going on. It was like a big thing. People came from all over the country to go to this festival. At that time, it's where our children would be safe and we didn't worry about harm coming to them. So Jesus was mingling with all of his cousins and his brothers and his sisters, and he was having a fabulous time. So he had wandered away from his mother and father, Mary and Joseph. He was about 12 years old. And how many times have we wandered away from God? Something to think about. How many times have we not said what we should have said? How many times have we not thought what we should have thought? And how many times have we went someplace we should have not went? Think about that. Now, how do I fix this? How do I figure out what's going on right now with little boy Jesus? Now, in Luke chapter 2, verses 41 and 50, we see that.
Hallelujah.
We see, hallelujah, just as Mary and Joseph was searching for their little boy, God is always leaving a door open for us to search for him. Now, before we get too far with this, I wonder how many times have we had God on our mind, but we didn't go toward him? How many times have you been going toward something you know God wants you to do, but you didn't go there? He leaves that door open so we can find him at any time. He leaves a window open so we can go through that window at any time. Now, we wander off all the time, but that's one thing about God. He allows us to make a 360-degree change at any time. And he forgives us for our sins. He forgives us for all the things that's going on, even with all the chaos that's going on in the world today. People still stealing, people still killing, people still committing adultery. Still, people are still doing the bad things they used to do before. But this pandemic is blocking all that, so you're losing focus. But please don't lose the focus of what God has in store for you. How do we experience God present in our life today? We, like Mary and Joseph, must look for what we love. Just as they look for their little boy, we must look for what we love also. And it's not far from us. We can still get the scriptures on our phones, on our tablets, on our computers. Or you may have a spiritual guidance, Big Ma or Papa, someone you can call to get that uplifting word so you can experience God in your life today. Now, as Joseph and Mary, they journeyed through looking for Jesus, they realized that they was going to have to go back a few days, 3 days back to find their little boy. They had lost him because they was having so much fun, just as we have fun in our life and we get off track. Now, but they found him. The message here is that it's easy to lose that special presence of God that it sometimes gets you off track, but it's always easy to get back on track when you lose it. We need to be careful, careful to remain in the presence of God, no matter what is going on around us or what is going on in our homes and in our workplace. When we do this, we make God first in our home. Now, our home is not just the building that we go in and close the door on. Our home is this body. This body is the temple of Christ. We must make sure that our heart is protected, our mind is protected, our ears and our eyes and that mouth, that dirty mouths of ours. We must make sure that we still show people love in everything that we say and we do. And when you say the wrong thing, don't be so stubborn not to say, "I'm sorry, forgive me." It is so hard for us to ask for forgiveness when we've done something wrong. How can we experience God present in our lives today? We must love one another. We must love one another. Even that person that doesn't have the same color skin as you. Even as that same person that don't look clean and pressed out like you and me. We must love one another because you could be entertaining angels. And one day, you're going to find out about it. We must love one another right now because our world is hurting. Our world is dying. People that I know have lost loved ones and they didn't get to say goodbye. We don't want to be in that shape. We must love one another. There is a simple way to start being obedient to his word. A commandment is to turn from our bad behavior and ask God in numbers of ways on how to love us and forgive us. This means that you should choose to be generous toward others. You should love to forgive others, but sometimes you have to forgive yourself. Remember that sometimes people are mean because they don't know how to forgive themselves. How can I experience God's presence in my life today? We must make sure that we offer up good sacrifices for him. And that could just be something nice that comes out of your thoughts and out of your mouth. And, excuse me, Holy Spirit. And Luke Chapter 2, verse 49, Jesus asked, "Why are you searching for me?" And we're at a point in our lives right now, we should be asking that question. Why should I search for you, Lord? Why? Why should I search for you? I'm searching for you, Lord, because I need your presence in my life today. I'm searching for you, Lord, because my family is hurting. Everyone around me is hurting. And this world is hurting. And I want to be happy in this life so that you will always be kind to me and love me so that I can always love you and show love by just being who I am. I'm searching for you today, Lord, because you said that if I search you, I would find you. You said if I knocked on that door would open for me. You said that if I stayed present, had you present in my life, I would always be in your bosom and I could feel you holding me. When no one else loved me, you would be loving me. I want your presence in my life today, Lord. I feel your presence in this room right now, Lord. It's different because we're not in the church building, and this was quite difficult for me today because I can't move the way I want, but it's not about me. It's about the word of God. How do I feel your presence in my life today? I will search for you, Lord, in the darkest of alleys, in the darkest of rooms. When I got to sit in a grocery store line just to go in to buy some veggies. When I got to stand in the line waiting to get gas and not being able to talk comfortably to the person on the other side of the pump. I search for you, Lord, in everything when I can't be with my grandchildren and this is my time to be with them. Because I don't want them to forget who I am and they're thousands of miles away from me. I search for you, Lord, because I know you're going to fix this. Because only you can. We must want God in our life. We must want to show his love by loving someone else. Because if we do not, we will not see him on the other side. When you choose to be very intentional on your words and give thanks to God and lifting him up, you will feel his connection all over you. There will be a warm feeling. A sweat will break out. A hallelujah good time will come into your soul. You may be able to talk, dance, shout, or you may just stand and be quiet. But that's your time that you know you have the presence of the Lord with you. When you have the presence of the Lord with you, you can't do anything but glorify and shout hallelujah to him. God is so good. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for loving me right now. Touch the hearts of all those who have lost family members right now. I've been getting texts and calls about friends of mine who's lost uncles and aunts and brothers to this virus. This is a nasty, evil virus that's going around. But it will be fought out and sought out because God is in most of our hearts here on this earth. We must continue to want him present in our life. Study to show thyself. Study to show thyself. If you say number one scripture over and over and over again, keep that connection with our Heavenly Father. I pray as I close. Heavenly Father, thank you for making your home in our lives today, for all those that tuned in to listen to this message. We need your presence in our lives today, Lord, so we can have your presence in our lives tomorrow. Help us to honor you with our thoughts and our words and control the words that come out of our mouths. If it's not of kindness, let us choke on those words, Father God, and ask forgiveness for that. Thank you, Father God, and continue to bless all those that are tuning in and loving on your words today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Oh, Lord, we praise you, we glorify you, we lift you up, for you are truly worthy to be praised. There's nothing like your presence, Lord. This is your time now to open up your hearts, open up your minds. If you need more anointing, open up your hearts, open up your minds. If you're lonely and you need a brother or sister, open up your heart, open up your mind. If you want a Lord that will never leave you nor forsake you, open up your minds, open up your hearts. This is your time to accept Jesus Christ into your life. It's nothing like having God in your presence. It's nothing like all things working together for your good. It's nothing like that, knowing that you could do all things through Christ that strengthens you. But you can't have that unless you let the Lord in your life. Will there be one today to accept the Lord Jesus as your Savior? To accept God's sacrifice for us that we might be brought back to him? Is there one this morning? Open up your heart. Confess with your mouth. Believe in your heart that Jesus is God's only begotten Son, that that he died for your sins, that he didn't stay dead, but he rose again, not just rise again, but he had all power in heaven and in earth. Jesus stands and he knocks at the door, asking to let him in, but he won't force his way in. You must let him in yourself. There's nothing like your presence, nothing like his presence. Hallelujah. Just listen to the song. Hallelujah. Joining in with us this morning, we pray that someone out there has found Jesus. Yes. And if you have found Jesus and accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, let us hear from you. Yes. Let us hear from you. You can send your letters and prayer requests to Camp Hope AME Church at 114 Camp Hope Church Road, Macon, Georgia, 31211. We've already started receiving letters. We've already started receiving requests. Let us know. And we ask that you would like this page. Amen. As we grow and as we glow and as we transform our thinking, we transform our minds that we might be as God would have us to be. Come grow with us here at Camp Hope AME Church. When this is over, come by and visit us as well if you can, and let us know that you were there with us all the time. And we pray that if you enjoyed this broadcast, that you would send us support, become a part of our family as we join in to do what we need to do. Now, as we always do, and as we know what we believe, we'd ask you to join in with us with the Apostle Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he arose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From this he shall come the judge to quicken the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Church universal, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. God bless you. God keep you. Join us again out here for those of Central Time. It will be at 8:30. For those that are Eastern Time, it will be at 9:30. Also on Wednesday at 5:30 Central Time and 6:30 on Eastern Time for our Bible study, and also for our ministry project management class. We will also be moving from this particular site to our home site that we're working on diligently in order to get it up, that you might meet us at our home base. Amen. Again, we thank you and we ask that you would join in and be with us and send in your donations to help pay for these broadcasts, to help us improve what we're doing, to help us be able to survive during this time. God bless you and keep you. May the Lord bless you. May he keep you. May he smile upon you. May he give you peace. May he keep you safe in the name of Jesus. We pray for Reverend Renfro, our other staff member, and her family, Lord. Yes. We pray for her daughter and her new marriage with Jamal. We just pray for all of our members externally and internally, all our family members internally and externally. Bless them, keep them, give them favor. Let your love be in them and around them and through them towards each other.
Yes,
is our prayer. Join in with me and say amen.
Amen.
Amen. And amen. God bless you. Amen.